What's the alternative career for Paolo?
Well, I started to dip my toe in the water with the carpentry, whittling wood, which I thought was a pretty nice way to spend.
So what
the
can
time.
You ma- what can you make? Because I remember at school. Do you remember at school they used to make you make a wooden letter on the feet,
trinket
for your parents? Yeah.
I'm pretty sure I could knock one of them together. But yeah, I'm not. It's all about techniques. I was starting to learn how to make some sticks, some walking sticks, and starting like that way. And I suppose the ultimate goal would be to do what my grandfather did for me. He made me a rocking horse when I was a kid. It's called Rocky. I've still got it.
Have you still got it?
Exactly the way it was. And ever since, the more I grew up and I appreciated that, then I had the notion that one day it would be nice to do the same for, if I'm lucky enough one day to have a family, then I could do the same for them, that would be, but then again, it's, as I said, I'm not really sure about what I would do, but I felt like that was in the back of my mind. I said, what could I do if I didn't want to do
that? I can't see you giving up and making walking sticks.
Yeah, well,
PaoloSticks.com. Have you already registered the website?
That's it. If somebody says something to fall back on, isn't it?
Yes, Paolo's walking sticks.
Literally.
You could sell them as merchandise at the end of gigs. Exclusive limited edition walking sticks.
Some of the my American gigs, the audience is like a kind of seen out a cocoon. So, maybe they would be good sellers.
Like Zimmer frames, you're talking about walking aids.
Put some lights around them, some disco sticks.
Yeah, to pimp them up a bit, yeah?
Yeah, man, Paolo's disco sticks.